Nakawa resident state attorney Barbara Komugisha this morning asked Nakawa Grade 1 Magistrate Court, presided over by His Worship Ponciano Oduoli, to commit the 8 suspects into General Katumba Wamala's attack to the High Court for trial with an amended charge sheet. The suspects' lawyers, led by Geoffrey Tuliam Sima, objected to this. The prosecutor was given more time to confirm the new charges. After several hours, court resumed with the prosecutor presenting the new charge sheet, reportedly approved by the Director of Public Prosecutions, Jean Francis Abodo. However, this too was rejected by the lawyers since it did not have a DPP signature and a court stamp to prove its authenticity. Presiding Magistrate Ponciano Oduoli adjourned the matter to tomorrow for prosecution to clear the defects in their amended charge sheet. This is the 5th time that the state is amending the charges. This time round, General Katumba Wamala has been omitted from the charge sheet, which leaves the lawyers in suspense on whether the state intends to bring him as a witness rather than a victim. The suspects have been slapped with new charges of murder, terrorism, aggravated robbery, and belonging to a terrorism organization, bringing the number of charges to 24 from 18.
It does not have evidence. That's the reason why they have kept on amending. This is the 50th time they're amending. They first amended from murder and attempted murder. They added terrorism. From terrorism, they added associating to terrorism. From there, they brought in now cheap hardware in Nansana offenses together with City Shopping Mall or City Shopping Supermarket in Kanyaya. They added them on the same, and today they have also amended. Now we are sure that they don't have evidence. That's the reason why for the last 6 months they have failed to rectify the actual problem. But be it as it may, we are sure that we are ready to proceed with the offenses for our client's sake.
Still in court, the chairperson of the Uganda Land Commission, Beatrice Biencha Nyakaisiki, has denied charges of abuse of office and obstruction of charge that she was charged with in the anti-corruption court in Kololo. Nyakaisiki, who arrived at court using a walker, faces charges of obstructing and hindering police officers from carrying out a search in her office while they were acting in exercise of powers conferred by the IGG Act of 2000. She is jointly charged with her 3 bodyguards, Constable Annual Richard Godfrey, Titus Wamono and Edward Turiatunga, who was remanded by the same court to Kitalia Government Prison. Prosecution states that the suspects on the 4th of January 2022 at the Uganda Land Commission in Kampala, without lawful justification, willfully obstructed Tumukurati Michael, Zakaria Tuberenda, and Superintendent of Police Noreen Akello from the Inspectorate of Government from carrying out a search in Nyakaisiki's office. Meanwhile, activist Rukira Bashaija Kakweza has been charged with 2 counts of offensive communication at Buganda Road Chief Magistrate Court. A charge sheet issued by the court indicates that Kakweza has appeared in court today, Tuesday, January 11, 2022. It is alleged that on December 24th, 2021, in Kampala District, Kakweza willfully and repeatedly used his Twitter handle to disturb the peace of President Yoweri Museveni with no purpose of legitimate communication. In another count, Kakweza is accused of disturbing the peace of the Commander of Land Forces, Lieutenant General Muhoozi Kainerugaba. It is alleged that on December 26, 2021, Kakweza willfully and repeatedly used his Twitter handle to disturb the peace of Muhoozi. The development comes barely a day after the High Court judge Musa Sekana ordered security agencies to produce him in court tomorrow, Wednesday, without fail. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.